always enjoyed the whole creative process of conceptualizing, scripting, shooting, editing, seeing what you can do with it, different ideas. So that's why I just started creating content, not thinking that it's going to go anywhere. Every time I've received a criticism for something, or every time I have failed at something, that's just been a learning curve.
Thank you so much for giving us your time and welcome. So I'm Divya, and yes, to the world, you're known as Barkha Singh, but to me, you're honestly like this fashion goddess. I am in love with your outfits.
Hi.
So you're welcome. All right. I want to start with talking, with a little bit of your acting. So talking about your series, Murder Meri Jaan is out now. So congratulations on that.
Thank you.
So this is a thriller. So what was your favorite part about shooting a thriller series?
So it is a comedy romance thriller. It's not like a full-fledged thriller because it does have comic elements and comic relief in it. So the whole show is about, like, my character that I'm playing in the show, her name is Sonal. She is a con artist. She basically marries them, dupes them, and goes. But I mean, you'll see how much of that is shown in the show and all. But the problem arises when she manages to marry an ACP. And if you watch the show, you'll know kaise hua, what circumstances led to it and how it happened and what happened and all of that. And then she gets hired by the commissioner as a consultant because she is a very smart and a sharp girl. And obviously the commissioner does not know she's a con artist. No one knows she's a con artist, but here she's married to a cop who's supposed to be catching her, but he's married to her. Right. And then how they solve cases together and how they have their own parallel romance angle going on. All in all, it is an entertainment package. I think there's something in it for everyone. And it's a very nice, warm show. And I'm not saying this because it's my show and I'm in it. But like in general, it's a very, it's something that, people would watch and turn off the TV with a smile on their face. After being taken for a very, all the plots, all the thriller aspect of it is also very, very intelligently written. Because like when we were reading and when we were preparing for this show and for the character, we also obviously didn't know the plots and who's the murderer and who's what and who's what. And like in workshops, I remember we used to just sit and keep guessing. And then when we actually reached that part of the episode for the reading, किसी का भी गेस्ट नहीं होता था, वो कोई और ही होता था. सो लाइक दैट वे पीपल आर इन फॉर अ प्रॉपर मिस्ट्री, मर्डर मिस्ट्री ट्रीट व्हेन दे वॉच द शो.
अमेजिंग. आई एम डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू वॉच द शो बिकॉज़ इट साउंड्स वेरी एक्साइटिंग. बट अकॉर्डिंग टू यू, व्हिच इज द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट जॉनर टू एक्ट इन?
I wouldn't say it's the most difficult, but I think it's quite to nail comedy is not the easiest. Because one, you obviously need to have the presence of mind because not always everything goes as planned. And two, you really need to have that comic timing. And if the timing is not there, things can go upanishi. So this is my personal opinion. Personally, I feel successfully pulling off something that's pure 100% comedy, like Charlie Chaplin level comedy, is one of the most difficult things.
Right. No, that definitely makes sense. So if you could ever give your old self any sort of advice, what would it be?
Don't worry so much about unit test marks. No one cares about your unit test marks.
Absolutely, yeah. Definitely. For sure.
Like I just wish I could go back. Like, yeah, definitely study for your prelims and your board exams and your final exams and get through the year and do amazingly well in your masters and everything. Yeah. But no one cares about unit tests.
I think and, like, the amount of stress that gave us more than us.
Yeah. So like, yeah. अभी मैं तो अपने बचपन को नहीं बोल सकती, तो hopefully there are some moms who are watching this. So
right. Definitely. For sure. Because I know for a fact it's not like we're gonna use any of those equations in the future or anything to do with whatever.
All those marks.
Marks.
Like unit test marks. I think the education system just does it so that we are constantly studying and we don't have to study everything at the end of the year.
Yeah,
but we made unit tests like the end. Like, oh my God,
yeah.
Do marks kaise kam aa gaye, oh ho. So I think that stress is not needed. We should channelize that energy into performing better and studying more.
Yeah, for sure. Definitely. Okay. So I have a couple of questions because you are also looked up to as an influencer, not just an actor. So I have a few questions on that as well. So I've also watched a couple of interviews of yours where you talk about considering yourself as an actor before anything else, because that's where you started. So being so good in your field, being an accomplished actor, what pushed you exactly into creating content or becoming an influencer above everything?
As I started acting and as more and more of my work came out, I realized that my following and my numbers of my social media, whether it was my Facebook page or my Instagram handle, they started growing. And like, I started receiving a lot of DMs and I started receiving a lot of communication from people from the other side. And this is at a time when I didn't create content. Like, I just put up photos, random photos of my life and friends and all of that. But that's when I realized that, you know, there is something out here. And again, this is at a time when becoming an influencer wasn't like really an insane that time. Like that time. I mean, this I'm telling you about a time when like people were like, "Acha beta, you create videos. That's what you do all day. That is your job."
In 2018, you started your YouTube channel. Right,
YouTube channel came in very late, but like Instagram and all was something which I started much before that creating content around 2015, 20 like around then, I think. So that
was the Vine age.
The Vine age, absolutely. To answer your question, when I did see a steady rise in my social media numbers, I felt that there is something that can be done here. And I have always enjoyed the whole creative process of conceptualizing, scripting, shooting, editing, seeing what you can do with it, different ideas. So that's why I just started creating content, not thinking that it's going to go anywhere. But thankfully it did.
And here we are. Absolutely. Okay, so what would you consider your best acting performance to be, if you have one?
I think as an actor, you keep growing and evolving. At least that's the case for me. So I'd always say my last project was my best project. If you ask me this, say a year later, I'll still say that my last project was my best project. So for now, I think I'm quite excited for my performance and for my character, not performance, that's the wrong way of putting it. I'm very excited for the character I got to play in Murder Meri Jaan, which is my latest release.
All the best. So what, according to you, is like the borderline difference between social media fame and clout?
The difference between having fame and clout is what you do with your fame. And that is where you can say that you have clout. When you are able to mobilize people into taking action for something that you believe is important, that you stand for, or just introducing them to new things and letting them take action for what they stand for. When you're able to mobilize people to action, that's when you can say you have clout and not just fame.
True. So what was that one failure which you think has now led to you having the success that you have?
I mean, there's not been one particular failure, to be very honest. There are ups and downs in the industry we are in. And, it comes with its own set of ups and downs. And I think every time there has been a down, that has been something that has pushed me back up again. So I think it will be unfair to point out one such instance, but I think every time I've received a criticism for something, or every time I have failed at something, that's just been a learning curve. And it also, to some extent, depends on how you take it and what you make out of
it.
So instead of getting discouraged, I generally choose to use it, like feel bad about it for some time, but then use it to just make yourself better and grow. So,
True. So what do you think are like the three stereotypes, or to put it in a better way, what do you think are three myths about content creators that need to be shut down right now?
What are the myths about us? One, we are not always happy. We have feelings too. So when you do decide to troll and put negative comments, it actually hurts. So yeah, one is that, and they're humans as well. The second myth I think I'd like to burst is that we are always brimming with ideas and we're always like upbeat and all of that. No, I think, and this is something I can speak for the entire creator community. All of us have like these days when we are flipping out because ideas nahi aa rahe hain and like you have deadlines and this thing. So yeah, like more than half the times we are panicking to, you know, land good ideas and all of that. And I think the third thing that a myth and the most important myth that I'd like to burst about creators is that humko sab kuch free mein nahi milta hai. We buy our things. Like,
I think
just
that's
really
important. Yeah,
because everyone's like, you haven't bought it. I'm sorry, but it doesn't always happen that my favorite brand is sending me a PR hamper. You know, our preferences hoti hai. There are certain things we like to use and those things we have to buy, like everyone. So yeah, that's one important myth we need to burst, that we don't get everything free. Very true.
Very true. Very true. Very well answered.
Thanks.
Okay. So I have a small this or that game segment with you.
Awesome. It's, okay.
Yeah, it's 10 questions. The first five is a little to get to know you a little more about. I mean, of course, they're all personal preferences. So the first five are on your fashion, basically.
Okay.
Your preferences on fashion, and the next five are very generic questions. So the first question is: so you have to just tell me what you prefer. Natural hair or colored hair?
Colored hair?
Yeah, okay.
It's fun.
it's fun. All right. No lipstick or no mascara?
No lipstick. Mascara is needed.
It's needed, right. I think this is a very common question you must get being here. Yeah. Okay. Heels or flats?
Flats. Flats.
Okay. Shorts or a skirt or like a nice dress?
Pajamas. Can I do that? Can I just pick up something randomly? Yes. Pajamas.
Very, yeah. That's more.
PJs for life. Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Frills or lace?
I think I'm a big girl now, so lace.
Yeah. Okay. So these are the five fashion questions. Now we have very generic questions. Who's your ideal type? The cute boy next door or the bad boy jock?
The bad boy jock.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. Your ideal date would be on the beach or at the movies?
On the beach. Because I like having good conversations and movies, maybe we'll just hear a lot of shh, shh.
Yeah.
So I think the beach is a good place.
And popcorn just coming flying at your head.
If you I don't want that. Yeah. On a date.
Avoid it. Okay. Sweet or savory?
Sweet. I love sweets.
Okay. Dine-in or delivery?
Dine-in.
Okay.
I'm a sucker for hot food, piping hot food.
Hot food. Yeah, yeah, very true. There's no fun if it's cold. Horror or comedy?
Comedy. I hate horror. I can't
you
watch
hate horror.
I never watch horror films, horror shows, horror videos, horror stories, nothing. I stay away.
No. Is there a backstory behind this?
No, like I don't know. Like I'm just very scared of bhoot. Like I don't know if it exists or no. But like like insano, so you can still like reason with them and talk it out. What do you do with a ghost, man? So like
true.
I'm just and like it just every time I watch something scary, that visual image just gets imprinted in my head. And then and I'm sure everyone experiences this, but like when you're sleeping, then I suddenly turn around and see if that ghost is there.
True.
Or like when I'm washing my face in the bathroom. Exactly. Yeah. Or like you know.
Yeah.
You have soap in your eyes and that's exactly when you feel someone's behind you. So like these things happen with me, which I don't really enjoy. So I just don't watch horror films.
Okay, thank you. And the last question for you, if you have a COVID message for your fans and for our viewers, what would it be?
That message would be, please stay home, please stay safe, double mask. But more importantly, if you think you can help in any way, just now our nation needs it. If you feel you are eligible to donate your blood, please donate plasma. Any of the links that you're sharing for COVID resources, a lot of us have been forwarding links. इंटरनेट पे काफी क्लटर है, सो प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट व्हाटएवर यू फॉरवर्ड टू समवन, बिकॉज यू आर फॉरवर्डिंग दिस टू डिस्ट्रेस्ड फैमिलीज who wanted in an emergency. So the least you can do is verify those links. So please verify karke hi links forward kijiye, your contacts forward kijiye. And yeah, just stay safe. Yeah, it's a tough time for all of us. And I think we should all be together and fight this together.
Definitely. Thank you so much. This was a lovely interview.
Thank you. So bye.
Bye-bye.